Hey guys, Marina here from Yes to Tech. Welcome to Tech Tuesday, where we remove the tech stress that comes along with running a successful online business. Today we're going to talk about how to create a brand board using Canva. A brand board is a single-page document that clearly and visually shows off all of your branding elements at a glance. Your logo, color palette, font and typography, keywords, and brand photography and style. You need to create a brand board so that your website, blog post, and social media graphics are all in line with the brand identity of your business. Stay tuned until the end of this video to learn how to create your own brand board for your online business using Canva and to get a free brand board template that you can use. Also, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every Tuesday when I post a new video. Alright, so let's get right into how to create a brand board using Canva. Logo and logo variation. If you don't currently have a logo for your online business, fret not. There are cheap and even free ways to create your logo online. I've linked to three tutorials in the description box below on how to create a logo even if you're not design savvy. The top 9 free logo maker tools, the Wix logo maker tutorial, and how to create your own logo online with a Designevo logo maker. When creating a logo for your brand board, think about coming up with a main logo that works when there is plenty of space, as well as a logo variation, such as this one over here, or this one over here. This logo variation or alternate logo can be just the initials of your business, the same logo in a different color or size, the logo with extra content, or even with content removed. Color palette. A good color scheme is integral to solid design, so it's important to pick the right mix of colors for your brand board. Stick to one or two main colors and one or two accent colors. Too many colors will be distracting and take away from design. When choosing colors for branding, think about what each color means and what emotion they evoke. Green can mean nature or money. Yellow can exude happiness. Black is usually used in luxury and high-end brands. If you need help finding a color palette for your brand board, you can use tools like Coolers or Color Lovers. These free tools will help you find color schemes that fit the mood and purpose of your website. Also, look at your competition and make sure that you aren't accidentally using colors that are too similar to theirs. Once you've picked a color palette, add it to your brand board and stick to it. Use it in all of your branding elements to help enhance brand awareness. Also, let me know in the comments below the main color you chose for your color palette. Font and typography. Typography is another important element of your brand board. Typography refers to the fonts used on your site, on your social media graphics, and has to do with size, style, and color. It can make or break readability, user-friendliness, and how professional your website looks. Here are a few ways to make sure your typography works for your brand. Stick with popular web fonts. There's a reason why you see similar fonts on so many sites. You want fonts that are easy to read and stand out against your background. You can use a free tool called Fonts in Use to see what fonts popular websites use, or a free bookmark tool called Fount to identify any web font that you see. Also, make sure that you don't use anything too cursive. It may look nice, but if a visitor has to work too hard to read the text on your site or on your social media graphics, they're likely to look for a solution to their problem somewhere else. Limit yourself to 2 to 3 fonts per page or graphic. On my site, I use Railway and Roboto. Just like with your color scheme, keep it consistent. Use the same larger font for all of your headers and subheads, and don't mix up the body font too much. Keywords. Think of three words that you would use to describe your brand and your business. What would those be? Maybe techie, empowering, dynamic, playful, fun, timeless, modern, fresh, cursive, formal, hipster, or maybe something else. Also, think about three words that you want your visitors to use to describe your brand, or even three words to describe how they should feel when they join your tribe. Are these the same as the three words you had come up with before, or are they different? Why so? You can also think of this as how your business differentiates itself from the competition. What makes your business stand out? What makes you unique and a better match for your ideal visitors than your competition? What makes you special? Once you've narrowed down the key words that you came up with to three options total, write them down in your brand board. Brand photography and style. A great way to determine the brand photography and style of your brand to include in your brand board is to search Pinterest for images that connect to the emotion you want to evoke when someone lands on your site. If you're lost as to what to search on Pinterest, a great tip is to get each of the keywords that you just came up with and search for it along with terms that relate to branding, such as design, style, inspiration, pattern, photography, brand, and branding. So what kinds of images, fonts, patterns, and colors go hand in hand with your brand's look and feel? Pin those photos to a new board. You can even make it a secret board if you don't want anyone else to see it, and have the aesthetic you're going for. And don't think about it too much. Go with your gut feeling. And if something appeals to you visually, add it to the board. You'll end up noticing that as you pin more and more photos, there'll be a number of similarities that pop up. Once you're satisfied with the images that you've saved in your Pinterest inspiration board, narrow them down to your top 3 or 5 photos and add these to your brand board. Now you know how to create a brand board using Canva. To make your brand board creation process easier, when you click on the link in the description box below, you'll get a free brand board template that you can use to guide you in every visual piece of content that you create. So, what does your brand board look like? Leave your answer in the comment section below and make sure to click on the link in the description box to get a free brand board template that you can use and customize. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.